Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to replace the famous Hollywood sign with your own text. I provided a template so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Once you open it, you'll see a photo of the Hollywood sign, the same photo without the sign, and a folder that includes the frames that support the sign. I included three different sizes that will accommodate characters with varied widths. I also provided the link to the font that matches closely to the one used for the Hollywood sign. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. The first step is to make a selection of the area of the hill where the bottom of the sign is hidden behind the stones and shrubbery. To do this, first, check your foreground and background colors. If they are not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Black should be our foreground color. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. Pick a hard, round tip. Make its size 10 pixels and its hardness and opacity both 100%. We'll zoom into the sign by pressing Z to open our zoom tool and dragging it over the sign. To reposition it on our canvas, press and hold the space bar as we drag the image. Press B to open your pencil tool again, and press Q to activate the quick mask. Draw over the contours of the hill just below the characters. Feel free to continue drawing over the contours to accommodate your text if it contains many characters. Continue to draw down, over, and continue the line until you connect with the point from which the line began. Open the Paint Bucket tool and click inside the area to fill it with the Quick Mask. Press Q to revert it into a selection. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 1 pixel. Go back to Select and Save Selection. Just click OK. We'll use this selection later. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl-D on Windows or Command-D on a Mac. Open your Horizontal Type tool and Type Picker. Open the SF Hollywood Hills font I provided. Make its size 95 points, the aliasing Smooth, and it could be any alignment. If the color box isn't white, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick white. Click on your document, type out your text, and open your Move tool. Drag your text to the top of the Layers panel, and Shift-click the Frame folder to make it active as well. Press Ctrl or Command G to place them into a folder. Open the folder, and open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl or Command-click the thumbnail of Alpha 1, which selects it. Open back the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. Make the base layer visible and active. Reduce its opacity anywhere between 50 to 70% so we can see the original Hollywood sign under it. Click the text to make it active and drag it over the Hollywood sign so the bottom of your first character is aligned with the bottom of the first character of the Hollywood sign. Go to Window and Character to open the Character panel. Double-click the text layer to highlight all your text. To raise or lower a character, drag your cursor over that character to highlight it, and place your cursor over the baseline shift scrubby slider icon. Drag it to the right or left to raise or lower that character until the bottom of it is aligned with the character under it. Do this for each character you want to raise or lower. Now we can close the character panel. Open back your Move tool. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.3 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Now that we have our text positioned on the hill, make the base layer active again and increase its opacity back to 100%. Make the frame folder visible and active. Shift-click the layer mask to temporarily hide it. We can now see the frames that were hidden by the layer mask. Drag them above your text. Now, reactivate the layer mask by shift-clicking it. Open the frame folder. Since the first character of my text is wider than the others, I'll click the frame wide layer to make it active. I'll drag that frame to my first character. A quick note, if you find that your entire background is being dragged instead of the frame, undo it by pressing Ctrl or Command Z and uncheck Auto Select at the top. When Auto Select is checked, wherever you click on the canvas, then that layer is selected in the Layers panel. The width of any frame should be slightly narrower than the character it's going behind. To adjust the frame's width, press Ctrl or Command T to open our Transform tool. Go to either side's middle anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. Its height should be at the top of the character or just below it. I'll use the middle width for the rest of the letters and the narrow width for the exclamation marks. Activate the frame you want to use and, as before, drag it into position. To make a copy of the frame for your next character, press Ctrl or Command J. Then drag that copy to the character it's going behind. Make another copy for your next character that has a medium width and drag that copy over to that character. Make more copies of that frame for the other characters that have medium widths. I'll make the narrow frame active and move it over an exclamation mark. I'll use my Transform tool to adjust its width. I'll make copies of it to go behind the other two exclamation marks. Next, we'll add a slight dimension to our characters. Collapse the frame folder and make your text active. To save a little space, let's collapse the smart filter. Make a copy of your text and double-click the original layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 1A0303. Then click OK on both windows, or you could press Enter or Return twice. Collapse the effects and make the frame folder active. Shift-click the top text layer to make it and the original text layer active as well. Convert them into one smart object. Reduce its opacity to 75% and hide the base layer. We can now see the original Hollywood sign under our text, so we can angle our text to the perspective of the sign. Open your Transform tool. To see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to the top left corner and press Ctrl or Command and the Shift key as you drag the corner in until it matches the angle of the H in Hollywood. Go to the top right corner and repeat the same hotkeys as you align your text to the perspective of the original sign. Now drag your text over the Hollywood sign. To accept it, press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. Make the base layer visible and increase its opacity back to 100%. Lastly, we'll cast a shadow of our new sign onto the hill. Press Z to open the Zoom tool and drag it over your sign. Reposition it if you like. Ctrl or Command click the smart object of your sign with the frames behind it to select its shape. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the selection with black. If your foreground color isn't black, press D on your keyboard. To fill the selection with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. Change its blend mode to multiply and reduce its opacity to 80%. Go to Edit, Transform, and Distort. Go to the top middle anchor point and drag it down and over to simulate the angle of the shadow that's being cast onto the stones and bushes on the hill. Convert the shadow into a smart object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Zigzag. The style is out from center, the amount is 65, and the ridges is 5. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.